Hi, this is Matthias here from Windsor.ai, and today I'll show you how you get Shopify data synced into Google Sheets. Before we start, you have to double check that you have rights to install an app in the Shopify App Store, and you need to have access to Google Sheets. Let's get started. First step is you go to onboard.windsor.ai, then you click on Shopify, and then you install the app on the Shopify App Store. You simply enter your URL, then you'll be prompted to grant access. Once that happens, you back in this user interface. Then once this is done, you go to Preview and Destination. Now over here, you'll have only Shopify. I have a few more data sources because I connected more for other demos. But over here, we select Shopify, and then you can start seeing your data coming in. So now it's verified. I have data. Shopify is connected. So my sample data, in my case, is coming in. And now I click on Google Sheets. Then you click this link here to install the plugin, which I have already done. And then inside Google Sheets, you click on Extensions, Windsor.ai. And now the first time you do that, you'll need to click on Login. Then you authenticate with your API key. You can find your API key down here. Simply hit the copy button and then insert it. And as a second step, then go into Get Data into Sheet. And then you can start selecting the different metrics and dimensions you would like to import. I click on Add New Query. And now I give that Shopify demo import. We can give the query name, so in case I have multiple queries, I can easily identify them. And then you give a target sheet name here. It's just sheet one. Of course, you can create your own sheets. Then here we select, again, the data source. So I would like to have Shopify data in. And now, in case I have multiple accounts connected, you could select from which accounts to pull. I'm not going to select any account, which means that data from all the connected accounts is loaded in. Then here, I can select the date range. I'd like to have the last 14 days of data. And then you can start selecting the fields. So now to keep things simple, I'm just going to query order email and order name. So I'm looking here for the email. And then I say order name. Then you see there are different objects. They're called. You have orders, for example, you have customers, you have marketing events, and so on. Just make sure that when you set up the query, that you query only data from the same object within one query. So no orders and customers in the same query. Keep it clean, create one import for orders, all the fields you'd have from the orders object, and then one for customers, for example. Then once this is done, you click on load data here, and then your data is imported. Now the data is here, so we see the same sample data like we have here. And now you would just repeat this process for the different objects and the different fields you'd like to have. And if you would like to refresh or have an auto refresh here, you could say, okay, refresh that for me on an hourly basis. And I would also like to have real-time data, so I could say I want the end date set to today instead of yesterday, so you always get fresh data in, including today. Then I click Save, and now this trigger, as it's called, will run hourly, and there is also an indicator here which turns red in case something goes wrong and which turns green in case everything is right. You'll also receive an email in case something goes wrong, and yep, that's it. Shopify is now connected to Google Sheets. Thanks very much for watching and have fun with our connectors.